Good morning, Eisenhower. I'm your special host, Amanda, along with
John.
Today is Tuesday, June 4th, Day A.
Today in history, on June 4th, 1896, Henry Ford completes the Ford Quadricycle, his first gasoline-powered automobile, and gives it a successful test run.
Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated.
And now for today's announcements with Benny and Don.
Good morning.
Benny.
What does today's weather look like?
Today, some clouds in the morning will give way to sunny skies for the afternoon, high around 75. Tonight, mainly clear, low 51. Tomorrow, a few afternoon clouds, mainly sunny, high near 75. And here's Don with today's announcements.
Thank you, Betty. DVDs of the spring concert are available for $5 each. The order form is available in the Friday folder section of the Eisenhower website. Be sure to get your order in before the end of school. There will be no Brainbusters meeting this Wednesday, June 5th. Those students who have already handed in permission slips, kindly meet Ms. Sloan in the front hallway, Thursday, June 6th at 8:25. Be sure to bring a bag lunch and drink. Attention Chain Link Club members. The Chain Link Club will meet on Thursday after school in Ms. Calangelo's room. Please make an effort to attend. Only two meetings left. Please see Ms. Zabel or Ms. Calangelo if you are unable to attend the meeting. We look forward to seeing you on Thursday. The Wyckoff Library Teen Writing Group will be meeting this Thursday, June 6th in the Monroe Room from 4 to 5:30 p.m. If you plan to attend, please contact Barbara, the teen librarian. Bring a piece of writing that you have done to read to the group. Snacks will be available at this meeting. All student council members should be planning on attending the Oasis Party after school today. We will be meeting in the gym right after school to set up and have a snack. The party will go on until about 6. See you there. Here's Benny with the rest of the day's announcements.
Thank you, Redon. Are you planning on attending Indian Hills? If you are, consider signing up for the Indian Hills High School Gymnastics Team. Our season is in the fall, which is from September to December. Anyone of any level is welcome to try out. If you are interested, please sign your name and number on the sign-up sheet. A current member of the team will contact you. If you're not sure if the gymnastics team is for you, come see for yourself in the Indian Hills High School cafeteria on June 5th at 3 p.m. The baseball and softball teams will be having a pizza party Tuesday, June 11th after school in the home ec room. Please bring your clean uniforms. The yearbooks are in and they are fantastic. However, if you owe a library book after June 10th, you will not receive your yearbook or report card. All library books are due back on June 10th and there will be no exceptions to this. Today in homeroom, all students receive notices listing the books they still had out. Remember to return all books to the library by June 10th. Any questions should be directed to Ms. Sloan. Next week, the Wyckoff Library will be hosting a zombie prom. Costumes are required. For Wyckoff teens, sit straight and up. On Friday evening, June 14th from 6 to 8. Contact Barbara about this event. Pre-registration is required and space is limited. Attention 8th graders, the promotion party is not a canteen. The promotion party is not a semi-formal. It is a graduation party with entertainment and catered food and opportunity to dance and take pictures with friends. It is themed in celebration of the Jersey Shore. There are no 8th grade parents chaperoning. RSVPs are critical for planning. Please don't miss out on this tradition. RSVP ASAP. Are we celebrating your birthdays?
Eisenhower wishes a very happy birthday to Ethan in 6A, Christopher in 7J, and Jake in 6D. What's for lunch today?
Today's lunch is pasta with meatballs. What's tomorrow's lunch?
Tomorrow's lunch is Wild Wednesday beef fajita bar. What's in the headlines?
Frank Lautenberg, New Jersey's five-term senator, died yesterday. Lautenberg fought the alcohol and tobacco industries and promoted Amtrak.
Now for today's feature with
Danielle and Matt.
Matt, what are you doing this Friday night?
I'll be at the Evening of Comedy presented by the Drama Club.
Well, let's go watch this feature on the evening, an evening at comedy.
Lights, camera, action. This year, Mr. Levy chose 2 one-act plays. The first one is called Trouble with Mothers and One Father. The second one is called Alienated. The play Trouble with Mothers and One Father is about how the daughters feel that the mothers are too strict and the mothers feel that the daughters are too high maintenance.
Alienated is about high school girl named Cammy who calls her fellow classmates together to investigate rumors of an alien in their community. Let's go meet some people involved in this production. I'm here with the fabulous Mr. Levy. So, Mr. Levy, what's going on with the spring play this year?
Because so many students love our theater program here during the year, our winter play, our spring musical, that they want to end the year doing something and putting on a production. So because there are so many other things going on in the school and at home and with homework and tests, we put together kind of a mini one-act play that we can get all the kids together again who want to do one more production. And then we put it on for one night only. This year will be June 7th.
So I'm here with Matt. Matt, what are you in the play?
I'm a father in Trouble with Mothers and One Father.
Are you enjoying the part you have?
Somewhat. But really, all in all, it's a really fun part, so I'm happy.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm here with
Mal.
So Mal, who's your character in the play?
I play Cammy.
Do you enjoy this part?
Yeah, it's really fun.
Thank you.
Yeah. Everybody going to be there? Be there or be square?
Be there.
Wait. Wow, sounds fun. Count me in.
Just remember, it's this Friday night. And now back to our
host, John.
And Amanda.
Thanks, Danny and Matt. And now for the joke of the day. Who likes to make dinner for Peter Pan?
Who?
Captain Cook. Thanks for watching, Eisenhower. Have a time of seeing Tuesday.
We'll be right back.